G'day crew. I'm finally continuing on with the Sonar series. Sorry it's taken so long to get this next episode out. I've been trying to figure out how I wanted to explain side imaging and getting some images and animations together to assist me, and it's taken longer than I expected. A side imaging transducer sends out two beams, one to port and the other to starboard. The beams themselves are very similar to the downvision beam I spoke about in the previous video. Similar in that the beams are wide, usually somewhere between 50 and 70 degrees, but very thin front to back. Front to back, the side vision beam is somewhere between 1 degree and 2 degrees usually. Again, similar to the downvision beam I spoke about. Now before I continue, I just want to give you a little bit of my background. I've fished since I was about 4 years old when my father bought me a little cane rod with a red and gold Mitchell reel on it. I still remember it vividly. My father bought our first Furuno sounder somewhere around 1967, and I've spent a good deal of my professional life dealing with various aspects of science and mathematics. I mention these points because what I have to say about side vision and how it operates is a little bit different to anything that I've ever seen before. Before I get into the nitty-gritty of how side imaging works, I want to spend a moment talking about what you see on the screen. Most of you are going to know all of this, but some may not, and I don't want anyone to be left behind when I start talking about the intricacies of it. I'm using a screenshot from my Hummingbird sounder here, but almost everything I say will apply to any brand. Most side vision displays will have something at the top of the screen to indicate the position and direction of the boat relative to the display. Hummingbird and several others use a boat icon for this. The very top row of pixels shows exactly what is under the transducer at the current time. All of the information on the screen below the top row is historical. That is, the boat has already passed over it and it is somewhere behind us. The central area of the display shows what is in the water column. I believe that understanding the water column is key to understanding side vision, so I have a lot to say about this area later. The area outside the water column is the ocean floor. Now, what's happening in the side vision is we are representing a three-dimensional environment in two dimensions on the screen. So the relationship between the water column and the ocean floor is a little complicated. And that's the whole point of this. I'm going to attempt to explain the relationship later with the help of some stills and some animations. In case you're wondering why the bottom on the starboard side doesn't look as good as the bottom on the port side, it's because I didn't tip the outboard leg up out of the way of the transducer beam. If you have your side vision transducer mounted on the transom, chances are you will need to lift your engine leg up to get a clear picture. Not all the way up, just up enough to clear the transducer beam. In my case, I have the transducer mounted on the port side of the boat, so the starboard side suffers if I don't tip the engine up enough. And if you've been wondering about the lines in the water column on this screenshot, they are from a couple of curious dolphins that came up to have a look at the boat as I passed over them. I mentioned at the beginning that my explanation is a little bit different from anything I've seen before. I think my explanation is correct, and I think it's better than anything I've seen before, but maybe not. Let me know in the comments if you think I'm right or wrong. Most people explain the black section in the middle of the screen by saying it is the water column, and that I believe is correct. It seems everyone then goes on to show a folded piece of paper to explain how the water column is flattened out, and I believe that is very misleading. Bear with me, and I will try my best to explain how I think it actually works. I'll start off by explaining how I think of the water column and why I think that. In my view, the water column is the blue area in this diagram. Now, how I arrived at this is partly based on what I have said in my earlier videos about the sonar shadow. Now, for the moment, just to keep things simple, I'm just looking at a flat ocean floor. Now, what I think happens is that the beam bounces back from the ocean floor and the sonar calculates the depth from the shortest ping return. This then becomes the depth and is shown on the screen as the black water column. But the water column isn't just the column of water directly under the boat. I view the water column as everything that is in the beam at that depth or less measured from the transducer. You can see what I mean in the diagram you're looking at now. The transducer beams are shown in a light grey colour. The area that is viewed as the water column is superimposed over the beams in blue. Now, I'll just say that again in a slightly different way that sometimes helps in understanding things. The water column is the depth of water under the transducer. Any fish that is closer to the transducer than the depth of the water column will show up in the water column on the screen. The vertical arrows here represent the depth of water under the transducer, and the horizontal arrows represent the width of the water column as it is displayed on the sounder screen. The arrows in the diagram are the same length, and both measure the depth of water under the transducer. Now, trust me, they really are the same length, even if they don't look it. The reason the horizontal arrows look shorter is an optical illusion caused by the triangle they are on. If you still doubt that they're the same length, get a ruler and measure them. They definitely are. And I'm just going to look at this same concept in yet another way, just to try and help everyone understand what I'm talking about. The triangle under the boat is the beam of the side vision transducer. The fish that are in the blue area will show up as dots in the water column area of the sounder. They may or may not show a shadow on the bottom, depending on a number of factors. I'll discuss some of them a little bit later. Fish that are in the beam of the transducer but outside of the blue area will show up as dots over the bottom on the screen. These fish will usually show a shadow on the bottom. As many other videos and instructables have said, the distance the shadow is from the target helps you to determine how far the fish is off the bottom. However, I think that understanding how side vision works and how it tries to portray a 3D world on a 2D screen makes the understanding more intuitive. If you've been following along and thinking about what I've been saying, you might be asking yourself why the water column is not the full width of the beam. The answer is simple. The water column is shown as the depth of water underneath the transducer, and that will usually be less than the width of the beam for the angle of most transducer beams. I'll just also mention that you can use side vision in water that is deeper than the effective range of the beam. This means you won't see the bottom, but you will get a glimpse of any fish that are in the water column. Now, the next question you probably have is, how is the seafloor displayed? Again, it's a fairly straightforward answer. They take the seafloor from directly below the transducer and push it outwards so that it is displayed outside the water column on the screen. I have used a couple of sounders that allow you to remove the water column and just show the seafloor. Now, since I've owned two different brands that have this feature, I imagine that it will be available in most other brands as well. Now, personally, I don't like this particular form of display. I'm probably a bit biased since I taught myself to read side vision with the water column in the display, and anything else just doesn't look right. I've superimposed a couple of images over the animation to show what it looks like without the water column. Now, you may be different, you may like it, so I suggest you give it a try and see what you think. So what's the biggest advantage of side vision? Now, in my opinion, the biggest advantage of side vision is that it allows me to survey a much larger area more quickly than traditional sonar. The animation on the screen shows the comparison between the width of a 6-degree traditional sonar beam as opposed to the side vision beam that we've been talking about. Looking at the specifications of several common side vision transducers, we can see that the side vision beam covers a width between 9 and 11 times greater than the traditional 6-degree beam. Now, this animation is the same thing, but this time comparing a traditional sonar with a 25-degree beam against our side vision beam. And the 25-degree beam is usually a low-frequency sonar beam. In this case, the side vision beam is covering approximately 4 times the area of the traditional sonar. This is important because it allows you to scan an area for structure and fish in less time, moving on to another area if you don't find anything. Another point I'd make about the side vision beam is that it is narrow front to back, so when you see something on the side vision screen, you know where it is in relation to the boat front to back. If you're seeing it on the cone-shaped beam of a traditional transducer, there's ambiguity about where it is, whether it's ahead of the transducer or behind the transducer, because it's a cone-shaped beam covering a large circle of the seafloor. Now let's introduce a rock below the transducer. I want to show you how this appears on the sonar screen. Now, because this is all done by drawing it, please be kind and allow me a little bit of artistic license here. As you can see, I'm not an artist by any means. However, I do hope that you can see what I'm getting at. This is supposed to be the historic view of the rock that we just passed over. The yellow area is the flat seabed surrounding the rock. The black area is the water column. The rock protrudes into the water column, showing that it is shallower than the surroundings. Let's introduce some fish into the scene. These are the same 3 tuna that I've been using in the previous videos. The top fish is 8 metres to port of the boat and 10 metres deep. The middle fish is 20 metres to starboard of the boat and 50 metres deep. The bottom fish is 12 metres to port and 95 metres deep. Now, don't worry too much about the actual measurements, it's the relative positions that are important. To understand how the sounder displays the fish that it detects in the side vision beam is also a little bit complicated, but I think I can explain it with the help of a few drawings and an animation. First of all, looking at the front view, you can see the 3 fish. I'm flashing some circles around them in case you're looking at this on a small screen, which will make it difficult to see where they are. I've also drawn some lines from the transducer through the fish to the seafloor. You can think of the part of the line from the transducer to the fish as the sound wave that hits the fish and is reflected back to the transducer. The part of the line from the fish to the seafloor is the sound shadow of the fish. Since the ping from the transducer has hit the fish and been reflected back, there is a sound shadow on the seafloor, just the same as there would be a shadow from an object that is in the way of a torch beam or the shadow of an object that's in the sun. I often find that the shadow on the seafloor is just as informative as the ping from the fish. Apart from the distance between the fish and its shadow being an indication of how far it is off the bottom, the shadow is often larger than the fish echo, particularly when the fish is further off the bottom. At times, the shadow can give you a clearer image and sometimes help you identify what sort of fish you're looking at. This is particularly true if you're running a sounder that has a side vision frequency in the megahertz range. And just to clarify that, the megahertz range is anything greater than 1000 kilohertz. In this image, we're looking at this from the top view, as you would in the sounder screen, but without the water column. You can see the fish and their shadows clearly. It is obvious where the shadow is for the fish to starboard. However, the 2 fish to port are not so clear. If one of the fish were ahead of the other, then it would be obvious. But since the fish are side by side, then we can only guess which is which. On the other hand, because this is a drawing and we've seen it from different angles, we already know which shadow belongs to which fish. The fish closest to the bottom has the closest shadow. The fish to starboard is in the middle of the water column and has the next closest shadow. The fish at the top of the water column has the shadow that is furthest away. Yeah, I don't think there's very much else that I can say about how I think side imaging works. As I record this, I feel that my explanation is inadequate, but after thinking about how to present it for a few weeks, I haven't been able to come up with anything better. I hope you've been able to follow well enough to understand what I've been trying to say. I'll just close off the video with a word about sonar frequencies. This image was captured from my Raymarine Axiom Pro when I had that. It's of a structure at West Peel Artificial Reef. This is the same structure captured from my Hummingbird Helix sounder. As you can see, the image from the Hummingbird is much clearer than the image from the Raymarine. There's nothing wrong with the Raymarine. It's a very good sounder. It's just that the Raymarine transducer transmits at a much lower frequency than the Hummingbird. Clearly, the higher frequency of the Hummingbird allows for a much more detailed image. But that comes at a price. The higher the frequency of the sonar ping, the shorter its range. In other words, you can search a wide area, or you can have a detailed picture of a smaller area. You can't have both, at least not with one sounder. Now, getting a detailed picture is great, but a long-range image makes scanning an area much faster. I like to have the best of both worlds, so I run two sounders. And I've been doing that for nearly 10 years now. I currently run a Furuno for the lower frequencies and its unmatched detection abilities. And I run a Hummingbird Helix for getting a high-resolution view of anything that I find. That is, provided the water is shallow enough for the mega-frequency of the Hummingbird to reach the object. Anywhere in the bay is fine, but offshore it gets deep enough that the Hummingbird doesn't help. And like Forrest Gump, that's all I have to say about that. Let me know in the comments if you think I have managed to present a reasonably coherent explanation of how side vision works. Don't forget to hit that like button if you got something out of this video. It really does help the channel. Thank you for taking the time to watch. Until next time, good fishing.